So before we start week six here, our offense has been sort of struggling. So we go out and we acquire Allen Hurns from the Jacksonville Jaguars. Gives us another receiver weapon. He actually would now become the number one receiver. And here we are in San Diego. We are sitting at 5-0. The Chargers are 3-2. This should be a very tough test. This Charger team is very good, but they will be out their big-time quarterback, Philip Rivers, so they will have to start their backup, I believe, as a rookie. So it should be interesting to see what the San Diego team can do. So here we go. We are underway in week six. Tucker's kick is in the end zone. They're just going to kneel it and take it at the 25. And sorry about my voice. I've been a little hoarse. So here we go. The quarterback for the Chargers will be Nick Heath. The rookie, still solid, 6 touchdowns. So here we go on 1st and 10 from the 25. They're going to play action. They're going to go out to Brown, and he will be up to the 30-yard line, gain of 5. So let's take a look at this San Diego offense. As I said, without Philip Rivers, still have a decent line with Dunlap, Light, Slauson, Fluker, and Barksdale. And then obviously the other big injury, no Keenan Allen. So Benjamin and Brown will have to take up the slack there. So on a 3rd and 5, they're going to hand off to Oliver. Kind of conservative play there. Mooney, the linebacker, filling in for Mosley, makes the tackle, and they will have to punt. So here comes James Christie. He has been up and down so far. Sometimes produces, sometimes doesn't. He's still young. So on a 1st and 10 from the 20, going to have to Melvin Gordon. Obviously Melvin Gordon drafted by this team. Didn't really do much. We ended up trading for him in year one. So this is kind of his, like, revenge game. So let's take a look at the Ravens' offense. Line remains the same, but obviously the big-time trade for Allen Hurns, he moves into the number one slot, Perryman to 2. And we're going to start Hobson over Williams. So on 3rd and 13 from the 17, back to the throw, and they're going to find Hurns. His first catch is a Raven. He is up to the 40, gain of 23 for the first down. Hopefully he can do more of that. So on a 1st and 10, Christie's going to roll out, and he gets crushed. Going on that bootleg there, that naked boot. So he gets crushed, and we'll take a look at the San Diego defense. So up front, have to watch out for Bosa. He is a big-time pass rusher, and so is Melvin Ingram. So these guys can do, and Perryman can fly around the field. And in the secondary, Jason Verrett, one of the best, with Hayward, Harmon, and Lewis back there, the former Raven. So on 2nd and 10 from the 49, they're going to hand off to Melvin Gordon. He's got some room to the outside. Tries to break a tackle. He's up to the 41, so a gain of 8. Solid start for Gordon, who hasn't really had the best of seasons. Touchdown-wise, maybe, but yards, no. So he goes up to the 37. He will pick up the first down. Moving the ball along here for the first drive of this Ravens offense. 1st and 10, they're going to roll out here on a play action, and he's going to go underneath the Hobson. Hobson trying to break a tackle, but he is brought down at the 30. So a very solid start here, gain of 8. So on a 2nd and 2, play action to Gordon, and they're going to find Hurns, and it'll be just a short completion, but he'll pick up the first down to the 25. Already his third catch here in this first drive. So on a 2nd and 10, Christie to throw, and he is looking. He's going to find Malcolm Mitchell. Nice throw, nice catch there, nice adjustment. Down to the 7, so that will be a 1st and goal. So now on a 3rd and goal in shotgun. Check while the running back looking underneath. Christie rolling out. He is looking. He will find Hurns for the touchdown. Welcome to Baltimore, Allen Hurns. First drive, 4 catches, and a touchdown. That is what we wanted to see. That's why we brought him here. Hopefully we can see that production from now on. As you see, Christie just rolls out, gets crushed by Legit, but he'll find Hurns right at the end. He goes in the end zone for the score, so the Ravens up here 7-0 here in the first quarter. So on a 2nd and 7, they're going to hand off to Oliver. Breaks off Mooney's tackle, but 2 more Ravens are there to make the stop. So that'll bring up a 3rd and 6. Brown in motion. Back to throw Heath. He is looking. He's got some time. He's going to go underneath the Oliver, but can't really lead him up the field. He is out of bounds, and that will be short. San Diego will punt. So running low here in the first quarter. Now Derrick Henry getting his turn, and he makes a nice run there. Good blocking. Gain of 8 there. Up to the 33. Derrick Henry has come on lately. And that'll be good near the end of the season because a lot more power run games in these cold weather games. So on a 1st and 10, Henry up the middle, gain of 13. So he is looking good here. So now we're going to go into the second quarter. And from the 46, Christian Theroux goes to the outside of Hearns. And he's got some room. And he is going 10-5. Touchdown. Walks his way to the end zone. Allen Hearns. What an impact in this first game. Two touchdowns already, as you see, just a little outside route there. Corner can't get to him, and Hearns outruns him. No safety there. He is in the end zone for the touchdown, so big-time start here for Hearns as the new Raven. So now San Diego down two scores just like that. On 1st and 10, Oliver makes a nice juke move, and he will be up to the 33-yard line. Gain of 8. So now on 2nd and 2, back to Oliver. Big hole up the middle. Jeez. And he has got the first down easily. So 6 carries, 22 yards. Not the greatest, but 2 nice runs there back to back. So on 1st and 10 from the 45, back to Oliver. And he makes another move. He breaks another tackle and looks like a gain of 12 up to the 43. So the running game opening up in this drive for San Diego. So 1st and 10, Heath back to throw. Goes across the middle. And he's going to find Hunter Henry, the tight end, for a big-time gain. So just like that, they're down to the 21-yard line. So now 2nd and 10. And Norris with the carry, and he's going to be brought down. That is Matt Judon there with the stop. So brings up a 3rd and 9. Ravens looking to bring some blitz here. See if they do. Yeah, they're going to bring it right up the middle. Nice cut block there by the running back. He'll find Benjamin to the outside. See where they spot this. Tlaib cuts him short. So that'll be 4th down. San Diego going for the field goal. And Cromartie Smith is there. He blocks the kick. San Diego will pick it up, but it doesn't matter. We'll block the kick. No score here for San Diego. They come up short. Off the edge, just flying off the edge was the rookie. And he blocks it, making an impact here on special teams. That'll make a name for you for sure. So on 1st and 10, back to throw, and he is brought down, sacked. That is Manti Te'o. So that'll be a 2nd and 20. So now we have a 3rd and 20. Christie back to throw. They're coming with blitz. He just gets rid of it. And Perryman just secures the catch. He is down. But the Ravens will have to punt. So San Diego gets the ball back with good field position from the 39 on a 2nd and 9. Oliver this time going nowhere. Aaron Donald with the stop. So a 3rd and 8. Back to throw. He is looking. He's got some time. He's going deep, and it is intercepted. Santiago Murdoch with the pick. He's had trouble with those his whole career, and finally comes with a pick. So now the Ravens about the ball. 2nd and 5. Going to go to Melvin Gordon here for the first down. Up to the 29-yard line. Christie looking good. 9 of 11. So that is a good start for him. So in a 3rd and 4 across the middle, and he's going to find Hearns for the first down. Gain of 7. Hearns already with his 5th catch so far. So in a 2nd and 5, back to Gordon, and he's going to be close to the first down. It's going to be 3rd and 1. So now to the 2-minute warning. Here comes Derrick Henry in the power back, and he's right up the gut. Big time run there. Picks up the first down easily up to the 33. 42 yards on 4 carries for Henry. So back to Derrick Henry, another big run. Tries to hurdle there, and he is brought down, but still up to the 22, another first down. Derrick Henry looking strong here in this first half. So now Melvin Gordon, he gets his carry, makes some move, and he is in the end zone. Touchdown Ravens, Melvin Gordon. He is just a touchdown machine. And now it is a 21-0 game here at halftime. San Diego having some troubles, can't get anything going. This Ravens offense looks a lot more balanced. It seems with Hearns in there, the defense has to respect the pass a little bit more. And it's opened up the run game for Gordon and especially Derrick Henry, who's looked fantastic. And plus, this defense is just playing lights out once again. It's a 21-0 game. Let's hopefully keep it up here in the second half, and then we'll get out of here with another victory. So we'll start off the ball from the 27. Christie back to throw. He's going to go underneath the Perryman. And he'll be up to the 32, and Perryman is down. That is not what you want to see. need that explosive receiver definitely out there, and hopefully he is not out for long. So we'll see here on 3rd and 4 from the 33. Christie to throw, and just a terrible throw intended for Hobson there, and we'll have to punt. So San Diego from their 10-yard line, 1st and 10. Heath is looking across the middle, and a wide open receiver. There's Brown, a gain of 30. He was just wide open across the middle there. So the biggest play for San Diego so far in this game. So now from the 40-yard line, the handoff to Oliver and Za'Darius Smith with a huge hit there. He's been making those plays all season. So now a 3rd and 13. Heath back to throw. He's got some time. And man, that was a heck of a throw. Wow, that was a gun and a half. Finds the receiver, Brown, for the first down. That was a bullet. So on 2nd and 9 from the 34, Heath looking, pressure coming, and he's going to go underneath to Benjamin. He'll pick up the first down, gain of 14, so San Diego once again driving here. So on 1st and 10, oh, that's going to be a read option. He's going to keep it using his legs there. He is up to the 7, gain of 13, so did not see that one coming. So first and goal here. They are just controlling this quarter so far. Long drive. And they're going to hand off to Oliver, and he is in for the touchdown. So San Diego gets on the board here in the third quarter and makes this a 21-7 ball game. Solid drive by San Diego. Let's see how this offense responds here. 2nd and 6. Going to try to find Max Williams. He has hit very hard, and he is down as well. So Perryman was down earlier, but he is just going to be out for this game. So now let's see what happens to Max Williams here. Hopefully he's all right as well. So 3rd and 6, back to throw, looking, just going to go underneath the check while trying to use the speed, but he can't use the speed to get the outside there. He is brought down. The Ravens will have to punt again, and as you see, an abdominal tear for Max Williams. So that is no good. See how long he'll be out after this game. So on a 1st and 10, going to Hunter Henry. He picks up the first down. So this offense looking a lot better here in this second half. So 2nd and 4. Back in the field is Oliver. Oliver is going absolutely nowhere. And Zach Mooney has made an impact getting in there and making those tackles for loss. So on a 3rd and 6. Heath back to throw. Wide open is the receiver. And that is complete for the first down up to the 42-yard line. A breakdown in coverage there. So 1st and 10, back to throw once again, going to Brown. He is brought down by Orr. He'll be a little short of the first down. But still, they are over the 50-yard line into Ravens territory. So read option again, and it doesn't work this time. Aaron Donald is there to bring him down. So this will bring up a big-time third down here. And they're going to throw the ball. Heath the throw underneath, and he's got Henry wide open to the 40-yard line. So they just keep these third down conversions here. They keep this clock running here in the third quarter. I mean, they pretty much own the time of possession in this quarter. So Oliver up the middle. He is brought down by Orr. So another third down here. See if we can finally get him off the field. And they're going to hand off to Oliver, and he picks up the first down. So another third down conversion, and the clock continues to run. So they're going to probably drag this to the fourth quarter. Here's a 2nd and 13. And they're going to hand off to Norris this time, and he's going to pick up the first down. So I believe we had 3 plays in that quarter. San Diego just owned it. We go into the fourth quarter up 21-7 still, but San Diego is right there. So now 2nd and 6 from the 11. They're going to put Henry in motion. They're going to hand off to Oliver. He makes a move, and he will be just short. So now 3rd and 1. See what they do here. Rolling out is Heath. He tries to go underneath, and it is intercepted. Zachary Orr with the huge interception here in the red zone on the 5-yard line. They had the blocked field goal earlier. Now Heath tries to go underneath. It is picked off by Orr. So 6 to 10 points taken off the board. The defense comes up huge. So now let's see what this offense can do. Maybe waste some clock here on a 2nd and 5. Derrick Henry, big time hole there. Nice block by Juszczyk. And he will pick up the first down and 79 yards on the ground. So second and five now to Melvin Gordon. He makes a move. Nice juke move. He is up to the 50-yard line. Gain of 17. So he has 84 yards on the ground. So now clock still running. 9:25 left in this ball game. Melvin Gordon. And he bought the balls loose. It is fumbled by Gordon. And just a terrible time. San Diego picks it up. So they will get the ball back here. See if they can take advantage. First and 10 from the 44. A wide open Oliver. And breaking tackles. Finally brought down at the 42-yard line. He picks up the first down. So from the 38, Heath back to throw. He is looking. He is sacked. Kafusi there. And a lineman is there to pick it up. But Bronson Kafusi getting right up the gut there, bringing down Heath. And luckily for the San Diego Chargers, a lineman was there. You see, gets right in there, ball's loose. And there's DJ Fluker to pick it up. If not, the Ravens would definitely had good field position and wasted more time to get this game over with. So in a third and 16, Heath looking, steps up in the pocket and is caught. Unbelievable. Travis Benjamin comes down with it. We said Murdoch has always struggled with those, and there it is once again. So now second and time. Oliver, he's got some room, and he's just going to be short at the 2-yard line. So a third and 2 here. They could still get the first down. They're going to hand off to Oliver, and he is brought down. There's a looms there, and it looks like Nandy. So this will be a fourth and 4. See what they do. They're just going to go for the 3, and this time they get it is up and good. So 21-10 game here. Surprised they kicked the field goal there. Still a two-possession game. So now a second and 8. Malcolm Mitchell has the reception. He's up to the 46. He picks up the first down. So now here we go. Keep that clock rolling here. Second and 11. 2:56 left. They're going to keep throwing it. Christie's going to go to Richards this time. Chris Richards with the reception. He's going to be close. So it'll be a third and 3. They'll still have to run a play here before the 2-minute warning. Just trying to pick up the first down here. He's going to go across the middle to Richards again. They're trying to strip the ball, but they will not be able to. But he'll be short anyway, so it'll be a 4th and 1. We hit the 2-minute warning. So up 21-10 here. It looks like we'll be in Tucker range. It'll be about a 54-yard field goal, but he can definitely make it for sure. So Tucker's kick is up, and it curls in and is good. So we are back to a 2-touchdown game here, 24-10, under 2 minutes left. So we'll see what the San Diego offense can do here, or this Ravens defense get a stop. So really quick pass to Benjamin. He is brought down by Orr. They're going to hurry it up here. They still have all their timeouts. But they'll need him if they get a score. Heath looking. He's going deep, and it is intercepted. Murdoch with his second interception of the game. And that will pretty much do it. Murdoch ending this game here. The Ravens defense coming up big there. So a 24-10 win here in San Diego. I know they didn't have Phillip Rivers and Keenan Allen, so that definitely helped out. But the defense did their job. The offense just enough. We didn't really have the ball in the second half. So the offense, we might have put up better numbers if we actually had the ball. But Christie, a very good game. 19-23, 2 touchdowns. Derrick Henry, impressive. 9 carries, 81 yards. Hearns, a great first game. 7 catches, 108 for 2. So that was good just to see right off the bat, get the pickup. And he produces in game number 1. So that was good to see. Mooney filling in for Mosley looked really good. Kafusi with our only sack, and Murdoch obviously with the 2 interceptions. So it's good to see him stepping up there. Really, their Heath, I mean, the 3 interceptions, not good, but he played well. But really give it up to our defense for getting those stops in the red zone, the blocked field goal, and the interception. So we move to 6-0. So we will go to week number 7 here against the Bengals. But before that, we'll check it out. Joe Flacco will be back. He will remain the starter. I don't think Christie has really shown me enough. He's looked good, but I'd rather just see what Flacco has. As for Max Williams, he'll be out for 4 weeks. As you see Mosley there, still out for 3 more. So Darren Waller will have to step in. He could be a big-time guy, so we'll like to see him. And now we face the Cincinnati Bengals. They are 2-4, but still a division opponent, so it should be an interesting one. So that is it. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you week 8 against the Cincinnati Bengals. Bye-bye.